Hello guys, how's it going? And welcome back to my video. And today we're going to be looking at the 10 most dangerous kids in the world, brought to you by The Richest. So if you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a like and please subscribe to my channel. That would be very appreciated. So, and if you guys have any other videos you want me to react to, either like try not to laugh, try not to be sad, try not to get scared. So, here we go.
Anyone with siblings knows that sibling rivalry is a very real thing. Yeah. And while it can lead to a few scrapes, it rarely escalates beyond that. However, there are the incredibly rare exceptions to every rule. Even rarer are the children that kill other children. What? Here are 10 evil children who took it too far. Christian Fernandez. In March 2011, 12-year-old Christian Fernandez was left alone with his 2-year-old half-brother in their Florida home while his mother ran an errand. While she was away, Christian brutally beat his baby brother to death. He was charged with first-degree murder, but in 2013, it was reduced to manslaughter when prosecutors learned of his troubling past. 10 years earlier, he and his then 14-year-old mother were found wandering the streets naked and alone. They were both placed into foster care as his drug-addicted grandmother was unable to take care of them. He had also suffered sexual abuse from a cousin and was beaten by his stepfather before the man committed suicide. Jordan Brown. In Wampum, Pennsylvania, 11-year-old Jordan Brown lived with his father, his fiance Kenzie Marie Hoke, and her 2 daughters. Hoke was 8.5 months pregnant with Brown's child on February 20th, 2009, when she was shot in the back of the head with a 20-gauge youth model shotgun while lying in bed. Hoke and her unborn infant son died as a result of the gunshot. Jordan claimed he shot his soon-to-be stepmother because he felt jealous about being replaced by a new baby. Thompson Toddlers. Houston, Texas resident Raquel Thompson and her boyfriend decided they would get a takeaway pizza in November 2015, but decided to leave Thompson's 3 young children at home. While they were away, the 3-year-old twins put their 19-month-old sister in the oven. By the time the mother returned, the baby had died due to severe burns. The toddlers later told police that one child had put their sister in the oven, and the other had turned it on and made it hot. No charges have been filed against the children, but Thompson and her boyfriend faced charges of child endangerment. Right. The twins and the 5-year-old sibling that had been asleep at the time were placed in foster care. Mm-hmm. Erica DiNardo. The DiNardo family lived in a good neighborhood in Novi Ligure, Italy, and seemed to the world a happy family. Their 2 children, 11-year-old Gianna Lucia and 16-year-old Erica, got along well, or so they thought. Unbeknownst to her family, Erica had developed a drug problem and a strong hatred for her family, which she wrote about in her journal. On the night of February 21st, 2001, Erica and her boyfriend hatched a terrible plot. While her father was at a soccer game, they murdered her mother and younger brother, stabbing them over 100 times. At first, police believed that the murder was the result of a botched robbery, but later recorded Erica and her boyfriend talking about their crime. They were arrested, Erica served 16 years in prison, and her boyfriend served 14 years. Girl A. On June 1st, 2004, an 11-year-old Japanese schoolgirl, known only as Girl A due to her age, murdered her classmate. Satomi Mitarai, a 12-year-old girl, was lured into an empty classroom during lunch by Girl A at their elementary school in Sasebo, Japan, before she was killed. Girl A returned to class following the event with her clothes covered in blood. Her teacher found Mitarai with slashes on her arms and her throat that had been slit with a utility knife. Girl A claimed she'd killed Mitarai because she commented on her weight. What? She was institutionalized in September of that year. Bever Brothers. In July 2015, Oklahoma brothers 18-year-old Robert and 16-year-old Michael Bever not only killed their siblings and parents, but they were also plotting a mass killing spree in order to gain fame as serial killers. Parents David and April Bever were stabbed to death along with 12-year-old Daniel, 7-year-old Christopher, and 5-year-old Victoria. They nearly killed their 13-year-old sister, but failed. She later told police that her brothers threatened to behead their 2-year-old sister as well, but she was left unharmed and went into foster care. The brothers were charged with 5 counts of first-degree murder and 1 count of assault and battery with intent to kill. Jasmine Richards.
I heard of this one.
In Medicine Hat, Alberta, a 12-year-old girl lived with her parents and 8-year-old brother. Jasmine Richards had apparently discussed killing her family with her 23-year-old boyfriend, Jeremy Steinke, several times, but she claimed it was always in jest. On April 22, 2006, Steinke entered the family's home and killed her mother and father. Richards told a jury that she was in a zombie state at the time of the killings and was unable to stop or go for help. She claimed that Steinke ordered her to stab her brother before slitting his throat. They were charged with first-degree murder for their crimes. John Venables and Robert Thompson. John Venables and his friend Robert Thompson were both only 10 years old when they lured 2-year-old James Bolger away from his mother on February 12, 1993. Surveillance footage showed the boys at the New Strange Shopping Center in Bootle, England, observing other children before targeting the little boy. 2 days after he disappeared, James's mutilated body was found near Walton, Liverpool. He had been tortured and beaten to death before being left on a railway line where he'd been hit by a train and severed in two. The two boys were arrested on February 20th and charged with abduction and murder. Keith Randulik. Chicago teen Keith Randulik was 19 years old when he told his mother he wanted a gun. He claimed it was to protect his 4-year-old sister Sabrina from a relative that was sexually abusing her, though this was never proven. His mother told him he couldn't have a gun and refused to buy it for him. On March 22, 2009, he took Sabrina down to the basement and stabbed her in the neck. He told police that she begged him to stop and asked him why he was hurting her. Keith was sentenced to 40 years in prison for killing his sister. Yikes. Well.
Wow. I just can't believe that. Wow. But that last one, not the one before the very last one, that was... I cannot believe they... I don't know why... What has gone into these kids' minds, I have no idea. But, well, so there you have it, guys. And, if you guys enjoyed the video, please leave a like and, hit subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys in the next video. So, bye, guys.